The album, musically, has been inspired by all the sort of stuff I was listening to when I was a teenager. And I was kind of just fed up with dance music for a while, because I'd made so many songs and done so many collaborations. I was just like, I want to leave house and trance and dubstep alone for a bit. So I went and listened back to all my favorite albums of the 90s, like Rage Against the Machine and Metallica and Beastie Boys and Nirvana and Smashing Pumpkins, Blur. And then all the producers who worked on this album, I kind of sat down and said, let's make a rock album, but produced electronically. So, i.e. a rock album, not with a band, but all done on computers with live guitars and stuff. So that was the kind of the starting point for this album. I just wanted to do a personal journey, really, for sort of a little snapshot of my life over a year ago. Like June 2011, when Change the Way You Kiss Me came out, went to number one, and then Stay Awake went number one, and then the album went number one, all in the space of like 3 months. I think it was just quite a lot for me, and I think I got a bit carried away, and I just regret a lot of things I did back then. In my personal life. So even though it looked kind of rosy on the outside in public eye, I wasn't that happy and in a good place personally. So I kind of just wanted to tell the whole world about that time, because I find that, you know, that real honest personal stuff makes really good emotional music. So that's where all the inspiration came from. Well, the first thing I did was I suppose come to terms with stuff by sitting down and chatting to my parents, who I was always close to, but they live in Australia, so I didn't, you know, really see them as much anymore. I saw them like twice a year. Same with my sister. Then I split up with my girlfriend so I could sort of like wipe the slate clean and start again. And then went to therapy and just kind of just stopped hanging around with a lot of people who I felt weren't my real friends, you know, just people I'd met since I became famous. So, and just kind of went back and rediscovered some of my old mates. And yeah, now I'm a lot happier for it. I mean, it's kind of weird because for me, all my best songs have been from really sad moments in my life. So if I'm really happy, I'm a bit concerned about what my music's going to be like. So I think I'm going to start telling stories about other people. Like, because all my biggest songs always had like a sort of gothic tone to them. You know, they're quite dark and haunting, and there's, you know, a lot of melodrama and melancholia. So I think I'm going to just start singing songs about other people rather than about myself. Because if I start singing songs about breakups and everyone knows I'm happy, it doesn't how it seems. There's not much integrity there, is there? If I had my wedding in the UK, I'd like to think I could ask Mumford & Sons or Ed Sheeran or Adele to sing, because I'm pretty good mates with them, all of those guys. So I'd like to think they'd sing one song for me. But because I'm probably going to get married in Australia, doesn't really give me any options. So, I don't know. If anyone knows anyone in Australia they can recommend who's local, then maybe we'll get them involved. Probably be a country and western singer, wouldn't it? Called the high five card. Someone's just made up the black card. No, it's the black card that gets you free food for you and your friends. Yeah, it's pretty much what all artists dream of. More than number one records, they want free Nando's.
What's your favourite Nando's?
I don't know, I just change every day. Because I go in Nando's maybe 3-4 times a week. If I'm out and about, I've got all the numbers on speed dial for all Nando's over London. Just call up. And like, they don't even ask for the card now, because most of the staff know that Example's got a card. So if I walk in, they just say, "Ah, sorry to come, please sit down, please take this. Would you like extra chips?" I'm like, "Yeah, give me extra chips."